Well, I'm really glad to be here today to talk to you about how you can connect Jira fields to external data sources and move away from what we call the silo effect. So what exactly is this silo effect I'm talking about? In our companies, we all use a lot of tools, several tools such as Jira, Confluence, Salesforce, or LDAP to get work done. And very often, we find that these tools are not so well integrated, which means they don't pass information to one another very easily. And that's what we call the silo effect. And this is the root cause of a lot of issues in our companies. In fact, three major ones. The first one is mistakes. When end users are working inside Jira and they input information in fields, they're more likely to make mistakes, misspellings, errors, and that makes it difficult to search this information afterwards or also to solve the user problem. The second issue that we face is that people spend a lot of time, and less time almost, searching for information. I'll give you an example. If you're working inside Jira and you need to access information about a customer that you have inside Salesforce, what you have to do is to open a new tab, log in Salesforce. That means you have a valid Salesforce license. Then you search for this account, the customer, you search for this information that you want, you copy it, and you paste it back inside Jira. So you lost a couple of seconds, minutes maybe, and you may seem that it is not big, but if we are 1,000 users at work companies and we do this 5 times a day, that makes a lot of time at the end of the year. The third issue is data duplication. So you maintain information inside Jira and you maintain it inside other systems, for instance. And if you do that, then you have duplicates. But this can go even worse. Let's say that you are having some information inside a LDAP about a user. And this information, for whatever reason, changes. If you have two referentials, you won't be able to see this change reflected inside Jira. And this can lead to wrong assumptions and errors. So that is something you want to move away from, and that's where our app, Elements Connect, can help. So what exactly is Elements Connect? It's an app that allows you to connect custom fields to external data sources. It works on Jira Server, and Jira Service Desk, and Jira Core, and it's available for Jira Server and Jira Data Center. And the idea is that you can connect to almost any data sources, ranging from REST APIs, remote files, SQL databases, and LDAPs. We fetch data from the data source, and we display it nicely inside Jira custom fields. So as you can imagine, it's a very powerful tool, a very versatile app. So today I won't show you an end-to-end use case. Instead, I'm going to show you 6 mini use cases that will hopefully inspire you in your day-to-day job to set up your own use case for your own company. So today I'm going to show you how you can retrieve external data and display it nicely for the 6 mini use cases. The first one is going to be fetching data, user data from a LDAP and displaying it inside Jira. Then we'll have a look at how we can get product details from a product catalog, such as Best Buy. Then we'll also see how we can get data from your CRM and display it within Jira fields, data about the user, the account, the opportunities, and so on. We'll also see how you can get relevant get relevant knowledge base articles, from an external knowledge base. Here we're going to connect to the Atlassian Community API. Then we'll see how we can get live exchange rate between different currencies, and we'll see why it can be useful for you. And last, I don't know if you guys know DeepL. This is a translation engine, translation software. And we'll see how we can use this translation software to translate content from within your issues. So now I'm going to show you how to connect Jira fields and say goodbye to data duplication and erroneous input. And to do that, I'm going to connect on our demo portal, which is based on Jira Service Desk. But what I'm going to show you on Jira Service Desk portal can work exactly the same with Jira software. So here is the first use case I'm going to show you, how we can get employees' detail from a LDAP. So first, we'll select a user and from a select list, and fetch these values from this LDAP, and then we'll see in the second field detailed information about this user. So this is our demo portal. Here on Jira Service Desk, we have a wide range of use cases, and you're going to get the link to this portal at the end of this demo. So the first use case here is how to get information about a user. So here I can start typing. And this is an Elements Connect field, and it's going to fetch information for me. So as I type, it will be automatically live updated, and I can get data about my user. So I don't have to manually input the data, and I get the right person. There is no risk of misspelling and errors. And here I see a detailed preview that's nicely handled in using some HTML, and that shows me the username, its role within the company, phone number. You could put anything you want inside this field. So what can it be useful for you? So you can use it if you want, for instance, to set the user's manager as the approver of a ticket. So what you would do is you would fetch that data from your LDAP and use it inside Jira as a custom field to be the approver of the ticket. You can also manage access requests. You can fetch information about the user, the apps that he has access to, the apps that he doesn't have access to. Display that inside Jira custom fields, the Elements Connect custom fields, and the user can choose which tools he wants to access to and make this request. And this is also useful if you want to display information about a user, the reporter of the issue, so you can really contextualize your queries. The second example I want to show you is how to look at product details from a catalog. Here we use Best Buy. So do any of you don't know Best Buy? So Best Buy is more or less the Amazon, similar to Amazon. It's a product catalog that has a wide range of products. And the thing we'll do is select a product category, and then we'll retrieve a product from this category, and we'll see information about this product. So here I'm going to select a category. So I'm going to start typing, and I get all the categories that match what I've typed. I choose this one, and see, this field is updated. So it's only going to display products that are from this category that I've selected here. So if I start typing, I'll get all the products, again, that match what I've started to type, thanks to this autocomplete. And below, I get product details nicely displayed in a table, and I also get the price of the product. If I go a step further and create my request, I can add links to the Best Buy catalog so that I can go to Best Buy if I need to. So it can be very useful for you if you want to, for instance, just like we did, place order to a supplier and see the price or the availability of your products in live without leaving Jira. You can also use it to provide your clients access to your own product catalog that you might have in an internal database, and so they can make orders, place orders to you. And you can go a step further and create a quote generator by connecting to a catalog and adding several products. The third use case I want to talk to you about is about connecting to a CRM and getting details about customers. So here we will select a client in a list that's filled with our Salesforce customers. And we get details about him, his account, and the opportunities that are currently being worked on this account. So here I can look inside the list or start typing. And I get all this information because there are dependencies between these fields. So if I had chosen, let's say, another client, I'll get different information. So moving back to Barbara, I see a role, department, email address, phone number. I also see the opportunities that are currently being worked on in this account. So it can be really useful if you want, in customer support, if you want to provide more context to your users. To the agents, sorry. So the agents, he can have detailed information about the account, the opportunities that are currently being worked on, and can provide a precise answer based on this context. It can also be used in the project management context. if you want to provide your project team with information about the deal that has been sold and such details or the contacts from the account that are relevant to get in touch with. And last, it can be useful if you want to offer support for multiple products. You can have your customers log into your support portal on Jira Service Desk, and based on their name, you can fetch data about the products that they've purchased. And so you only display the products that they have purchased in Selectlist, and I can choose to get help on the products that they own, not have to look into a long list of all products that are not relevant to them. Bonus here. So because you don't have to have all your Jira users using Salesforce to go and look details inside the product on Salesforce, then you can save on Salesforce licenses by only providing licenses to the people that need to input data inside Salesforce, not the people that just need to access information infrequently. The fourth use case is how to suggest relevant knowledge-based articles. So I guess most of you guys are very familiar with the native integration between Jira Service Desk or Jira Software and Confluence, where you can display relevant knowledge-based articles from a Confluence space. Here, what we'll do is a bit different. Because what we're going to do is we're going to connect to an external knowledge base. Here, it's going to be the Atlassian community, which you all know about. But it could be a Confluence and fetching information from several spaces, if you have information stored in several spaces. So we'll start typing a summary of a request, and we'll automatically get relevant knowledge-based articles from the Atlassian community. Let's have a look. So here I'm going to start typing. And I get a list of knowledge-based articles that can be relevant to me. So I can choose one, and even before creating an issue, I can get a solution to my problem. Whoops. So the idea here is, like I said, to provide a solution to the user's problem before the user creates the issue. So reduce the number of issues that you receive on your support portal, and you let users help themselves. But it can also be useful if you want to display the knowledge-based articles only on the back end to the agents. So you can standardize processes and improve agents' onboarding by providing them the processes they need to follow, and steps and information. The fifth use case is about getting exchange rates. So here we'll select two currencies that we want to convert, and we'll fetch from an API information about the today's exchange rate. Sorry, I'm going to try between euros and US dollars. And here I get the exchange rate that's currently in use. So it can be useful if you're managing a business project, especially if you work with you're managing your proposals inside Jira or costs, and you want to you have multiple currencies that you need to convert. You can use Elements Connect fields to store the value of the current exchange rate. And it can also be useful if you have we work in a global company, you have several offices, several currencies, and you want to manage reinvoicing between several business units. The last example I want to show you is how to display the translation of the content inside the Jira ticket. So we're going to start typing a ticket description, and we're going to view the English translation of the description field and get the detected language. I'm French, so I'll type in French, for instance. Ta-da! Here's what I get. So I can see the translation, and I also get the detected language. So it can be useful for two things. First, to automatically translate requests to English. If you get requests from someone who doesn't speak your language, you can still understand what this person meant and provide a solution to his request. But it's also useful if you want to automatically route tickets based on the detected language. So here, we detected it was in French. We could send this ticket in the queue that's managed by the French-speaking team so they can provide the answer to the request. So everything I've showed you is available online. All the examples I've just showed you, you can connect to this portal here and try them, play with them for yourself. And I'd like to wrap up with summing up what we've seen. So we've seen that we can query almost any data sources. Here in my examples, there were mostly web services, but you can query any database, such as Oracle databases or PostgreSQL databases. The second thing we've seen is that Elements Connect Fields allows you to fully contextualize your queries. What do I mean by this? I mean that you can contextualize your queries by using issues variable. Here we selected manually the users, but you could say, I want to fetch information about the reporter or about or to get information depending on the context of the issue, really. And you can also set dependencies between the different fields. Here we have a dependency between the contact fields and contact details, for instance. And we can also fully customize the display of your fields, meaning you can use HTML or native UI components to really customize how your field displays, so it's relevant to your users and it makes more sense. So I think you all remember at the beginning of this demo, I talked to you about the silo effect and how it affects our companies on a daily basis, how we lose time every day manually going to fetch information in another tool and going back inside Jira. Well, I hope that now you know that you can rely on our app, Elements Connect, to make data flow between your different systems, and you can move away from that silo effect and save time for your teams. Thank you very much. And if you have any questions, we're on the room at the back. Feel free to come.